A monkey. Welcome, Vikings, to the virtual January, February, and March assembly. I'm Sahara, and today Josh and I will be your host. Hope everyone's doing well and managing online school. I know it's been difficult, but there's around 61 more days until summer break. Today's assembly will look a little bit different. Instead of virtue awards, we will have class awards. There will be some jokes along the way. Hope you enjoy!
Wow, hi. My name is Josh, and you'll be seeing more of me later. But for now, let's move on to our first award by the amazing Malkia. Take it away!
First award to be given out is the award in most energetic. As the name suggests, it's for the class that is the most energetic in our school. Whenever you see them, they're almost always running around, enjoying life to its fullest, as that's what they like to do. They also enjoy things that get them moving, such as recess, scavenger hunt, or even just going out for some fresh air. Along with all this energy they hold, we found a curiosity aptitude within most of the students in this class. However, we decided that their energy stood out a bit more. And so, we get the award of being most energetic to Miss Ramsey's kindergarten class. And now, here are some pictures of the amazing people in this class.
So our next award will be done by none other than my co-host and friend, Sahara. So take it away, Sahara, and show them our next award.
The next award I'll be presenting today is the Happiest Class Award. Of course, there were many classes up for this award, but one stuck out in particular. And the award goes to Miss Fernandez's SK1 class. Especially these times, it's hard to stay positive. But despite having to be online, Ms. Fernandez's SK1 class has done an incredible job doing so. We are very impressed with you guys, and keep it up. Congratulations! Did you know that the Toronto Maple Leafs are closer to winning the Stanley Cup than ever? Speaking of hockey players, Andrew will be presenting our next award.
Hello, I'm Andrew, and I'll be presenting our next award. The most accepting class. The winner of this award is Ms. Degnello's class. Everyone here accepted the changes that we had to face, but Ms. Degnello's class also had to accept that they would have a new teacher. Congratulations, and well done. Thank you.
do you get if you cross computer and a hamburger? A Big Mac. If you're having trouble with your computer, Clarence is the guy. Take it away, Clarence!
The award I'll be presenting now is the award of the most diverse classroom. This classroom award goes to Ms. Minot's class. The BAP classroom is hardworking, positive, and engaging. They have learned about different cultures of the world and what they do. Some highlight moments include making African toy vehicles and projects on different countries of the world. Congratulations and great job from Ms. Minot's class for winning the award.
So far, or at least the best day that I can get out of our current situation. I will be calling upon Anne for the next upcoming award that will be given to one of our classes.
Hey everyone, Anne here, and I will be presenting the next upcoming award. This award is very important because it truly shows how much art can show love and school spirit in our St. Victor community. Through class projects, participation in school events, and everyday school activities, I think that this class, in particular, deserves the Creative Arts Award more than anyone here. Even through COVID-19 and all the precautions we had to take this year, I am very pleased to say that all the classes were able to use their creativity throughout these past couple months. So without further ado, I would like to present the winner of this award, Ms. Karczewski's Grade 3 Flips. From always packing a punch with the school-wide decorating competitions, to always having amazing assignments out in the hallway, I would truly like to be proud of all of you for your accomplishments. Don't forget to also thank your teacher for all the care that she puts into teaching you. Thanks everyone, and I hope to see you all back in school.
Another transition for this next bit. Now, on to our next award. So, this award is going to be presented by our one and only Jessen. Take it.
After much thought and consideration for the title of Miss Dunbar's class, we settled on Dunbar's preteen athletes. This is due to their dedication to DPA in the mornings and all the extra exercises that they perform. We'd also like to acknowledge Ms. Denborough's own achievement, most virtually approved teacher. Well done! What's a cat's favorite subject in school? Music. That was funnier in my head. Next is Jessen.
Hello. Now for Mr. Sabiano's class. A thing we've noticed with this class is that they've been extremely well with adapting. Of course, this year has been a little unique for all of us, but this class in particular has had many changes with student switching. They've done a great job with adapting change, so we've given them the title of Most Adaptable. We also acknowledge Mr. Sabino's title, Best Jokester, as he's helped make things more cheerful with his jokes and pranks. Well done!
Congratulations on your award, Mr. Sabino's class. To present the next award, we have the one and only Madison.
Hello there. I am here to announce that Ms. Suss' class has won the Most Games Played Award. This is because during free time, whenever any work is accomplished, they enjoy spending the time to play games.
Our next speaker says he doesn't read Fortune, but he has eaten a lot of their cookies. Introducing Josh.
The next category is a decorative slash artsy category. This category goes to the class with the most artistic talent. This award represents the class's creativity and love of art. So this is a perfect award for the gifted grade 6th class. From start to finish, this class has always been filled with art from drawings to paintings to even sandpaper art. This class has got it all. So who better to give this award to than them? Presentation, hasn't it? Well, I mean, I hope it's been, and yeah, I know that I said that I haven't seen any of it yet, but who cares? Now, on to our next category, done by yours truly, Joy.
Hi, I'm Joy, and I will be the award presenter for Mr. Conley's class. This class, like all other classes, is a tight-knit, friendly, and an assortment of wonderful people. Mr. Contley's class has displayed two of the most crucial traits when working in a group, coordination and cooperation. Every team has these two traits, so what's so special? The special part is in the bond that everyone shares. The level of cooperation and in turn their coordination with one another is what makes it so noticeable. Especially in their games of soccer during recess, it's hard to find other classes who are so in sync with one another. That's why we're presenting Mr. Contley's class with the Coordination Prize, truly deserving of the class with strong bonds. Congratulations!
Monsters eat fish and chips. I mean, where would they get chips from? Anyways, Josh is presenting the next award.
Hello, my name is Josh, and I am here to announce the winner for some of these awards tonight. The next award is the Community Award. This award goes to the class that has helped the school community the most. This award shows not only the selflessness of the class, but how much they have done to help the school become a place for all. So this award is perfect for Miss Malia Michelli's class. Miss Malia Michelli's grade 7-8 class has been a very integral part of the St. Victor's community, from the scheduling of events to saying the announcements every day. No matter what they do, will always have a lasting impact on not only the staff and students, but also the entire St. Victor's community. The second to last category slash award slash whatever you want to call it. And I honestly really enjoyed being a part of this, and maybe next month y'all will get to see us make something like this. I don't know. Anyways, on to our next category, done by yours truly, the one you've all been waiting for, Moses.
The largest Snow Day Snowball Award goes to a class that has worked very hard over the course of weeks to make the largest snowball. Probably the largest one that St. Victor has seen. And what's more incredible is that they made it while wearing masks and social distancing. This special award goes to Mr. Pinter's class. Great job with the dedication and the final product, breaking St. Victor Guinness records.
Thanks, Moses. And now I introduce a man who is clever and witty, and I can go on and on, except I'm having a terrible time reading his handwriting.
Take it away, Niccolo.
Thank you, Sahara. No need to thank me for my amazing handwriting. Well, before I introduce the award, I want to tell you guys a story. Mr. Brunsky's class received a new student, Daniel, in January. You see, this student was and is learning how to walk and required extra attention from staff, but was still accepted into Mr. Brunsky's class as one of their own. Each person put in a great deal of effort for this to happen. Justin helps push Daniel's wheelchair during recesses. Daniela enjoys Daniel's company throughout the day. And Angelina works well with Daniel in group projects and takes interest in how Daniel explores his environment. Everybody is welcome in St. Victor's, and everybody has a place, and it's heartwarming seeing how Mr. Brunsky's class takes initiative to incorporate every person into their classroom, seamlessly and comfortably. The Most Welcoming Class Award goes to Mr. Brunsky's class. Congratulations.
That it's over, but be happy that it happened. And yeah, some of you are happy that it's over, but just bear with me, okay? This month's virtue was justice, and maybe you could look back and see if you did anything related to justice. And next month's virtue is going to be compassion, so maybe look out for any time where you can show compassion, or maybe just try to show a little bit of compassion every day. Doesn't matter how. Doesn't matter to who, just try to show compassion. So yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed this little presentation of ours, and maybe you'll be looking forward to our next one, if there is going to be a next one. And if you didn't, maybe tell us why and what we can improve on. So that's it from me, and from the rest of us here in Mr. Cho's Gifted class, thank you for watching, and goodbye for now. We hope to see you again real soon.